In today's note, we're going to look at multiplying and dividing powers. So in our last note, we looked at what powers were, and now we're going to look at how can we work with them when we multiply and divide. So just to kind of get an idea of what we're dealing with, if I have an exponential form of 3 to the power of 2 times 3 to the power of 4, I want to expand this to see what does this actually look like. So 3 to the power of 2 is 3 times 3. And if I multiply that by 3 to the power of 4, or I'll use a different color, 3 times 3 times 3 times 3, what am I actually seeing here? So yes, I have 3 to the power of 2 times 3 to the power of 4, but I just have a bunch of 3s that are multiplied together. So what I can do is I can simplify all of this, and realistically I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 3s multiplied together. So I could rewrite this as 3 to the power of 6. Let's look at my next example. I have 4 to the power of 3 times 4 to the power of 3. Again, if I want to expand this, 4 times 4 times 4 is my first 4 to the power of 3, and then I'm multiplying it by 4 times 4 times 4, or another 4 to the power of 3. Again, this is just a bunch of 4s multiplied together. And we know I can express this as a single power as 4 to the power of 6. If I look at my next example, 6 to the power of 4, or 6 times 6 times 6 times 6, times 6 to the power of 1, or just 1 6. Again, I can simplify all of that to 6 to the power of 5, because there's 5 6s all multiplied together. If I try to make this a little different and use 3 sets of these, 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 for my 2 to the power of 4, times 2 times 2 for 2 to the power of 2, times 2 times 2 times 2 for 2 to the power of 3, this can all simplify to 2 to the power of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 2 to the power of 9. Even if I use letters instead of numbers, k times k times k for k to the power of 3, times k times k times k times k times k for k to the power of 5, I can simplify this to k to the power of 8. So rather than going through all of those steps and expanding and then simplifying again, I want to try to find a rule to make this easier. So if I compare my exponential form with my single power at the end, what kind of pattern do we see? And the idea is now, if we look at our exponents and how they relate, we can see that if I'm multiplying powers, I can add the exponents to get my answer in the end. So my rule is, if I have x to the power of a, x to the power of a, and I'm multiplying it by x to the power of b, my simplified form is x to the power of a plus b. So I'm just adding those two exponents to give me my new final exponent. So if we go back to our examples, 2 plus 4 is 6, 3 plus 3 is 6, 1 plus 4 is 5, 4 plus 2 plus 3 is 9, 3 plus 5 is 8. So we can see where that rule comes from. One thing to note, the bases must be the same for the rule to work. So if we look back at these powers, the bases are always the same. 3 and 3, 4 and 4, 6 and 6, 2, 2 and 2, k and k. So the bases have to be the same, whether they're numbers or whether they're letters, they all have to be the same in order for these rules to work. Let's move on to dividing powers. So dividing powers, again, let's investigate this, go through the same kind of steps. 5 to the power of 5, so we'll do 5 times 5 times 5 times 5 times 5, divided by, and we know fractions represent division, 5 times 5 times 5. Now I want to simplify this. So if I want to simplify this, if I multiply by 5 and then divide by 5, I can just cancel one on top and one on the bottom out. Same thing for the next one and the next one. And if I want to simplify this or look at it, I end up with 5 times 5, which simplified is 5 to the power of 2. Let's move on to the next one. Again, 7 times itself 4 times for 7 to the power of 4, divided by 7 to the power of 1, or just 7. Again, same idea. I want to simplify this, so I'm going to cross one out on the bottom, cross one out on the top, and this simplifies to 7 times 7 times 7, or, as a single power, 7 to the power of 3. You may be seeing the pattern already. The next one, we have 10 times 10 times 10 times 10 times 10 times 10 for 10 to the power of 6, all divided by 10 times 10 times 10 times 10 for 10 to the power of 4. And again, cross one on the bottom and the top out. And you can see that you're left with 10 times 10, or as a single power, 10 to the power of 2. If we look at the next example, 2 to the power 7, so 2 multiplied by itself 7 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, all over 2 to the power of 6, so 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. If we go through and cross them out, we're left with just 2, or as a power, remember, 2 to the power of 1. And lastly, even if we throw number or letters into this, P times itself 8 times. So P times P times P times P times P, 7, 8, all over P to the power of 5, so again 5 P's all multiplied, and then again cross out one on the top, one on the bottom, because you multiply and divide by the same thing, cancels out, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, crossed out one too many on the top. So I'm left with P times P times P, or simply P to the power of 3. Again, we could go through and expand every time we have a power divided by a power to find our final answer, but we want to come up with a rule that's easier. So if you can see the connection between the exponential and the single power, you should see that the rule is, when I have x to the a divided by x to the power of b, my simplified form is just x to the a minus b. So I'm subtracting my exponents. Or another way we can write it, x to the a over x to the b is a minus b. So I'm subtracting my exponents when I divide. And you can also think of multiplying it, or dividing is the opposite of multiplying. So if we have to add exponents when we multiply, it makes sense that we'd have to subtract exponents when we divide. And again, one note, same as the last one, we must have the same base for the rule to work. Right, if you look back at all these examples, they all have the same base. If you have the same base, you can divide or you can subtract your exponents and use the rule. If you don't have the same base, you can't do that. So let's go through some examples. I'll do the ones on the left and you can do the ones on the right at home for practice. So 3 to the power of 2 times 3 to the power of 2. This simplifies, or because we're multiplying powers with the same base, right? We have a base 3, base 3. I can use my multiplying powers rule. So in this case, it would be 3 to the power of 2 plus 3, or my two exponents, which works out to 3 to the power of 5. Now I also want to evaluate this or find out what this works out to. So 3 to the power of 5 is 243. For B, same idea, I'm multiplying powers. I do have the same base, they're both in brackets. So this becomes negative 2 in brackets, right? We talked about this in the last note. So negative 2 in brackets to the power of 4 plus 3, which becomes negative 2 to the power of 7. And this simplifies to, or is evaluated to, 128. For C, same thing, multiplying powers, I have the same base. So this becomes 1 over 2 to the power of 4 plus 1. Remember, because we don't see anything here, that means my exponent is 1. So 4 plus 1, this becomes 1 over 2, or a half, to the power of 5, which simplifies to 1 over 32. Or as a decimal, 0.03125. Because I'm, for example, D, I'm now dividing powers, so my rule is going to change. I still have to make sure that I have the same base, which in this case I do. So now my rule for when I'm dividing powers is I subtract them. So 7 minus 5, so that means it becomes 8 to the power of 2. Which is 64. For E, I have a negative decimal, and that's still fine. As long as the base is the same, the rules stay the same. So this becomes negative 0.5 to the power of 6 minus 3, because it's negative 0.5 to the power of 6 divided by negative 0.5 to the power of 3. So I subtract my exponents, 6 minus 3, becomes negative 0.5 to the power of 3, and this simplifies to 1 over 8, or as a decimal, 0.125. For example F, this looks a little complicated. Again, what we learned from order of operations, when we have kind of things in our fractions where we have multiple things in our numerator denominator, we want to solve for them first individually and then worry about the division later. So first things I want to do, I want to simplify the top. I do have a power times a power, so I can use my power rules because I have the same base. So 3 over 4, and my power rule says I have to add my exponents. So 3 plus 2 becomes 5, and I'm going to divide by 3 over 4 to the power of 5, and now I can work on the division. So when I divide powers, again, check to make sure they have the same base. In this case, they do. So 3 over 4 to the power of 5 divided by 3 over 4 to the power of 5. I subtract my exponents, 5 minus 5. So this becomes 3 over 4 to the power of 0, which equals 1. So again, even though I have multiple power rules combined, I want to solve for my numerator first, then worry about the division. Lastly, a colony of bacteria doubles every hour. There are 30 bacteria now. how many will there be after each amount of time, and show your work. So after 1 hour, so I have 30 bacteria, if they double every hour, so that means after 1 hour, it's 30 times 2, which becomes 60. So that means, so therefore, after 1 hour, there is 60 bacteria. For 3 hours, so that means I have 30, and after 1 hour, it doubles. After another hour, it doubles again. And after another hour, it doubles again. So very similar to our paper folding question at the beginning. So this could be simplified to 30 times 2 cubed, or 30 times 2 times 2 times 2. And this becomes 30 times, so 30 times 2 to the power of 3 works out to 240. For 12 hours, again, start off with 30, after 1 hour it doubles, and it continues to double every hour, so that means it's going to double 12 times, so 2, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, so 30 times 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 30 times 2, 12 times, or simplified 30 times 2 to the power of 12, which works out to 122,880. So after 12 hours, that's how many bacteria I have. And finally, for n number of hours, so if I don't know how many hours, I just want to come up with a formula. I know, looking at my past examples, it'll be 30, and then it's going to multiply it by 2 because it doubles. And then if I don't know the number of hours it's doubling, or a number of periods that I'm looking at, I'll put 2 to the power of n. If we look back at all of our simplified examples, whatever the exponent was on 2 was the number of hours that I was looking at. So if I don't know what the number of hours are, I will put n in as a placeholder. So that's my formula for n number of hours. And that's looking at multiplying and dividing powers.